Lem Satterfield. I'm here with a man who's a legend in to Baltimore City Wrestling, and that's Mr. Dwight Warren. He has become a mentor to me, and he's also a mentor to many, many, many kids. Dwight, you had a state champion 2 years ago, I think it was. What a great moment it had to be for you. Perseverance. Tell us a little bit about that kid. He is what this kind of banquet, Unsung Heroes, is all about. What he overcame, how he turned himself from a bad student, potential criminal, into a stellar athlete and a stellar student athlete who is now, I think, at the University of Maryland.
No, he's at Hopkins.
Okay, well, go ahead. You tell me.
Okay. Well, once again, just want to mention a little bit about the success that we've been able to have over the years, and particularly 2 years ago, we had a stellar athlete. I will say this, a gentleman by the name of Lance McCoy. Just as Lem just pointed out, Lance was perhaps headed on the wrong course, but he found in wrestling a discipline. And believe it or not, this kid worked very, very hard. He was not the kind of kid that had it natural. He was the kid that had to work hard, and when you get on the mat, it's going to be a brawl. Yeah. And that was part of his success. The fact that he's always allowed himself to go a little bit above the crowd. You know, he worked extremely hard. He stayed in shape. And to see this kid come back from a regional loss, to come back to win the states, was probably one of the, I know it is one of the moments that I would cherish for the rest of my life.
Well, you guys, the city has only had four state champions. I guess Tyler Hinton from Carver won the four state championship. The other one you had a connection with, Barrett, Deshaun Barrett, you coached him.
Yes, sir. He was one of the kids, and Lance McCoy. Mm-hmm. So, and as the record says, there's only been five state champions since the city merged with the county. Well, fortunate for me, I had in my stable at one time two of them.
Right.
And it's quite an honor. Plus, this is something that'll last him for the rest of his life.
Now, tell us a little bit about Lance McCoy, where he's at now, and how you use him perhaps to encourage other kids who might be headed down the same path that he once was before turning himself around.
Yes. Lance was fortunate to be granted a scholarship to attend Johns Hopkins University. There is a situation, there is an opportunity in the city. If you're within the top 5% of your graduating class, Hopkins will offer you a scholarship. Lance happened to fit that role. He was offered a scholarship. He's in his second year at Hopkins. Unfortunately, he keeps having a similar problem with his shoulder that he's not able to compete. But the other thing about it, as I said to Lance, it's not about wrestling. It is about getting that degree. It is about meeting people. It is about this new experience in life that you were having. That's the key to success.
Dwight, it's a pleasure to see you here. We love this banquet because the unsung heroes are stories that Lance McCoy falls into. Thanks a lot for being here, and congratulations again on your success as a state champion.
Okay, thank you. Again, Lem, he is really our hero. He is the one that put Baltimore City Wrestling on the map. And I know that Lem's commitment to kids is unyielding. I love him.
All right, you the man. Thanks.
Okay.